Good morning, students. So, students, today we will discuss the production of wool from the sheep. So, student, we have earlier discussed the animals yielding wool. So, student, now let us start. Students, the fleece that we get from sheep is processed to make wool and woolen clothing in the following step. It means there are the many process for the production of wool from sheep. So student, first process is shearing. What do you mean by the shearing? The process by which the fleece of sheep is removed is called shearing. You can see this diagram. Rear remove the sheep, rear the fleece from the skin of the sheep. So this is the process of the shearing. So what do you mean by the shearing? The process by which the fleece of a sheep is removed is called shearing. So student, it may be done by using either clippers. You can see in barber shop, and the barber uses to shave a man beard, or a shearing machine. Shearing does not hurt the sheep as the hair. Shearing does not hurt the sheep. Why? Because the hairs are the dead cell. So you know, written here, shearing does not hurt the sheep as the hairs that are sheared are dead. Sheep are usually sheared in the hot weather, because in hot season there is no need for the sheep when they do not require their fur. It actually helps the sheep to survive in the hot season. And this process is done, student, in the cold summer season, not done in cold season, because they protect the sheep from cold. So this process shearing also done in the hot season, and shearing also helps the sheep to survive in the hot season. Understand? Now next process, scouring. What do you mean by the scouring? Now the washing of the fleece, remove fleece with water. Why? Because they have the dust, dirt, grease also. So what do you mean by the scouring? The process by which the sheared fleece is treated to remove dust, dirt and grease is known as scouring. And the sheared skin and hair are thoroughly washed in a series of tub. Not in a one single process. There are the many series of tub, and one by one they washed with the water. And nowadays machines are used for the process. You can see this scouring, and this is a machines and wash again and again. So what do you mean by the scouring? The process by which the sheared fleece is treated to remove dust, dirt and grease is known as the scouring. And it is done by hand also, and nowadays a shearing machine is also used for this purpose. Now student, sorting. Sorting means hair of the different texture are separated from each other. There are the different texture of hair, and there are the small small fluffy fibers are there. You can see your woolen clothes also, the burrs are there. Many times you can see the small fluffy structures are there, fibers are there on your woolen clothes. So this is these are called the burrs. So small fluffy fibers called burrs are removed. The wool fibers then remain are scored once more and dried, and now separated the wool, then again scoring with water, and then drying in the sun. Understand? What do you mean by the sorting? Hairs of the different textures are separated from each other by sorting. You can see this. They remove the rears, are remove the burrs from the wools. Now after the separating, they again scoring with the water and machine also. So you can see this picture. Now student, grading. Now the group togethers are there, grouping of the wools, because the many varieties of the wools are there. So the wools fibers are grouped based on their length, fineness, color, texture and other characteristics. So this process is called grading, And we can say that the different grades of wools are used to make different woolen product also. I have discussed earlier in last video, there are the some wool make is used to make the shawl also, some used in carpet also, hosiery also. So they are the different texture, different length, different colors. According to their, we can say that their characters. So different grades of the wools are used to make different woolen products. I hope you understand all this process: shearing, scoring, sorting and grading. Now student, dyeing. After the grading, what will happen? Dyeing also, because if we talk about the natural fleece of the sheep or goat are the black, brown or white in color. So after the fibers obtained from them are dyed in various color. Understand? Dyed with the different colors. Next process is student, carding and spinning. So what do you mean by the carding and spinning? Carding means student, the fibers are straightened, combed by passing them through roller. There is a, you can see this picture, there is a roller, and then pass through this fiber into the rollers, combed also, and this process is called the carding. Now the fibers, these fibers are twisted. Now these fibers are twisted to make yarn, and this process is known as spinning. The fibers are then twisted to make yarn by the process of spinning. A spinning frame is used for this purpose, and the yarn is wound onto the paper cones or spindle for easy use in weaving and knitting machine. Then after the yarn is bound into the paper also, paper cone also, your spindles also, for easy use, they use from the spindles also, we can say the cone also, they remove easily and easily use in weaving and knitting machines. Now student, last process is weaving and knitting. Now yarns are knitted or woven by hand or in machine to make fibers. Now what will happen? Yarns are knitted or woven by hand also and in machine also to make fabric. Knitting uses a, what is the difference between the weaving and knitting? If we talk about the knitting, knitting uses a only single yarn. Knitting uses single yarn. If we talk about the weaving, more than one yarn. Understand? Question can come in the examination. What is the difference between the weaving and knitting? In student, in knitting uses a single yarn, while the weaving using the two or more yarns. Other difference between the weaving and knitting: longer woolen fibers are suitable for knitting. Longer woolen fibers are suitable for knitting, while shorter fibers are suitable for weaving. Understand? What is the difference between the weaving and knitting? Knitting uses a single yarn, but weaving uses a more than one yarns. And knitting fibers are longer woolen fibers are suitable for knitting, and shorter fibers are suitable for weaving. So I hope you understand all the process in the production of wool. So I hope you understand all the process. So read these all the process, students. And what is the difference between the carding and spinning? What is the dyeing? So all these process you should be learn. Understand? So okay students, bye.